Hi and welcome to my channel. My name is Magnus and today we're going to talk about Checkpoint R80.10. So Checkpoint R80.10 is end of support in May 2021. That's only 5 months away, so it's time to start to think about upgrade path. So what do you need to think about when upgrading and what version should you actually pick? So first of all, if we check like what is the widely recommended release today, there is an SK for this that is called SK95746. Within this one, Checkpoint discussed the terminology like major, GA, hotfix, etc., etc. And in the bottom of this, they say the currently releases. So as of today, in December 2020, the widely recommended release is R8040. This together with the latest general availability Jumbo hotfix. But as you see here, R81 is also released. And R8030 and 20 is still under support. So if we check like for example R8030, that is a very popular release. R8030 and 40 will be supported until September 2022. So what should you actually pick? And if we start with the software, it's like, how much risk are you willing to take? And what functions do you actually need? So risk itself is divided up to like two parts, I would say. So first of all, it's the risk of not having the function that you actually need for your business. I mean, do you need dynamic objects? I would say you do. And if you need that, you need to be above R8020. So I mean, you're fine if you upgrade it from R8010 to something. But R81, for example, it brings hit counts for NAT. Is this something that you really need? R8040, it has some great features when it comes to VPN. For example, VPN domains based on community. And maybe that's enough for upgrade to that release. So this is something that you need to think about. Like, what functions do you actually need and what should you map it to? And then there is the risk of not having a stable release. And what I mean with that is, like, for example, R81 is released here. R81 was released 2 months ago. I mean, don't get me wrong here. When a release is made public and it's GA, Checkpoint has already done like internal testing. They have had the EA program and so on. So they have tested the release. But as you all know, when you release something, you release it together to get new functions out on the market, to stay ahead or to catch up with a competitor. In this case, maybe FortiGate or Palo Alto or similar. When Checkpoint has enough confidence in a release, they will make it the widely recommended release. And this takes a while. I mean, this maybe takes a year because it's not until you as a customer has installed the releases and tested it. So the release needs to be in a large enough environment. It needs to be in a large amount of devices to actually be considered to be stable. The more and more customers that install these releases, the more data Checkpoint actually gather. Either if you send the metrics to them by automatically, it's if you install the product, you can select if you should share anonymized data to Checkpoint. This is a metric. But I mean, they can also check, for example, tech cases. How many cases do Checkpoint get in on a specific release when the customer is using specific functions? In this way, Checkpoint can make a decision if this is a stable enough version. And during the lifespan of the software, Checkpoint will release HFAs or Jumbo hotfixes. This is to address issues that has either been found internally or by customers or partners. But it can also be, at least now, before it wasn't like this, but at least now, Checkpoint also backports some functionalities that are in later releases that they want to add to an existing one. Because Checkpoint also understand that it's hard to upgrade to a major release. You need to plan, you need to evaluate the release and so on. So some functionalities Checkpoint want to port back to an older version where they have a wider adoption to test it. And just keep in mind, your environment can still be divided. For example, you can have R8040 on your management stations. That gives you the possibility to use this new VPN functionality. But you can have your gateways on R8030. Or you can have an R81 management server and a R81 gateway. Or you can have... You can mix the recommendation, and it was a rule before. And it depends on the major versions and so on. But in general, as a general rule, you can say like the management station needs to have the highest release. Meaning within your environment, the management station needs to be the highest version. So for example, you can have an R81 management station, and you can even have an R77.30 gateway controlled by this management station. But you're not able to have a R77.30 management and controlling a R81 gateway. If you want to check like which versions are compatible with each other, you can go to the release. I will go to the latest one because it has the latest compatible list. And then you see here, backwards compatibility map. So here you see, if you're running an R81 management station, you see here management stations. So an R81 management station can manage an R77.30 gateway. But if you have an R77.30 management station, this one, you cannot manage later gateways. And just an example, if you have an R8030 management station, you are able to manage R8040 gateways. So this is a list that you need to check, especially if you're doing new installation and adding clusters to your management station. And be aware of the little star sign here. For example, if you have an older release on your management station and then add a later release gateway, it's not sure that you can use all the functionalities of that one. Just so you're aware of it. And this is something that you need to check in the release notes. But this is a great way to start like what is actually working with each other. Because if you're planning to upgrade your management station, you need to make sure that you can manage all your gateways. Maybe you need to do multiple steps in upgrading just to fix this. When you have decided to like what version do you actually need to go, that is stable enough for you, that's supporting your gateways, and you can have the functions that you want, then you need to check if your hardware is actually supported. So for example, when a major release is released out to the public as a GA, and the major releases are like R77, R80, and R81. Actually, R8020 is a major release as well. But Checkpoint has promised to change this, so it will be a new first number if it's a major release. When a new major release is available as GA, this is something that also discontinue a few appliance boxes. It requires more stuff to actually be run. So if you're running appliances, and even if you're running your stuff in VMware or open servers, you need to check if your software is supported on your hardware. My personal view is, of course, that you should run your management station in an hypervisor, such as VMware. And I prefer open servers. We can have a discussion about that later, but I mean, it's fine if you run either appliances or open servers, but you need to make sure that your software is actually supported on your hardware that you want to go to. So how can you check this? Well, there is a few ways. So one of the easiest way, it's to actually use the upgrade and download wizard. And it can be found if you go to R81 here, for example, And at the bottom, I think you have it. Yeah, here. Then you have upgrade and download wizard. Then you get here. So then you can do an upgrade. So next, here you can select the product line, for example, a management station. And let's say you have a smart one appliance. And just for the sake of it, we take the smallest one that, let's say 25. So this is a really small box. And we're running Gaia because Secure Platform is really old and you shouldn't be running that. But, well. So you see here, for example, the latest version that you can upgrade to from R77.20 is the R77.30. So this specific box cannot even run R80. So that means that if you want to be in supported release, you need to change that box. So if we go up like a step to, let's say, 150, and you have Gaia, and let's say you're running R8010, because that's what we're discussing. The latest and greatest release that you can put on this box is R8030. So if you want to run R81, you need to change your box. And this is if you're running management station. If you're, for example, running gateways instead, there are different preferences. So I'm not so great with appliances. I'm not sure which one is which, but let's say enterprise and do 4400. I have a few of those for out-of-band management network. Gaia, and we're saying we're running them in R8010, and I want to upgrade. R8040 is the latest and greatest I can run on those box. I suspect it has to do with memory. So if I take a bigger box like 12,200, it's a bigger box. I can still only upgrade to R8040. And this also has to do with like the support that is in question as well. And I can show you this one. So there is a life cycle when it comes to appliance support. And if we go down here, we have the appliance support life cycle. So when an appliance is released, we are over here. So we have not even started on this one. But when the successor, the new replacement for the box is announced, then you have more or less 1 year that you can get the latest and greatest software fully supported. But you have almost 3 years that you can get the minor hotfixes, minor releases, like for example, R8020 to R8040. That's within the same main train, but it's maintenance releases, small hotfixes. And then it's more or less end of engineering support. This doesn't mean that you're out of support completely. You can still get some fixes and upgrades, and it's based on, it's based on how many stuff is still available and how severe the cases is. And you can also get the hardware replacement, an RMA. So when the successor is announced, you have 5 years until you're completely out of whatsoever support. So when you have decided your software version that you want to run, and you have checked every box that you have in your environment to see if they are actually supported, then you can start upgrade planning. So it can be a bit time consuming, but this is something that you should check, especially when you go to new major releases, because this can be a real issue if you find this out later. It's much better to find it out before and then plan for it. Maybe you need to ask for a new budget, maybe you need to replace some stuff, or maybe you can just go for it and everything will be working perfectly. One thing more that you need to check before you do an upgrade, especially if you need to do multiple major releases or multiple releases, then I recommend you to check the upgrade map as well. And this map, it describes you how you should upgrade. So let me zoom. So for example, if you have an R77 release, you are able to upgrade directly to R8040. But this is something that you need to check. If it's a nice little checkbox, no problem. If it's a checkbox with stars, read the release notes. But I hope that everyone is running at least R77.30. If you are, please upgrade. Personally, I will upgrade gateways to R80.30 with a late HFA. And the management station, I will go with R8040 or even R81 in some cases, because there are some nice features that that I want. And when it comes to like having different releases on the different products, I'm fine with that. Checkpoint says that you should try to have the same release everywhere, but I say like this, if you have issues on your management station, it's easier to handle than you have issues on your gateways. So I normally upgrade my management station and run it for a few months before I actually upgrade gateways, because you can get some nice features by only upgrading to the management station, but you cannot take advantage of exactly everything until both the gateways and the management station are on the same release. So just have that in mind, but this is something that you should think about when upgrading, and that you can need multiple steps when doing upgrades. And one of the reasons why I would go for R81 for management station is to have it easier to upgrade my gateways. But if I go for R81, your lowest version supported on any of your boxes in your environment needs to be R77.30. So, well, it depends on your environment. And just to make it fully clear to everyone, I mean, even if you're running open servers, like I do, you still need to check the compatibility list, because not all servers are certified for newer releases or older releases. For example, if we do an HP and we do a gateway, then you can see here the newest HP servers, the Gen 10, you're not able to run an R8010 version of this one. You need to have the 3.10 kernel. And I would skip the R8020 completely. I think that release was not very good. So if you're running an HP box, R8030 and Gaia 3.10. That would be my pick. But remember then, you need to have a management station supporting this. So for example, let's say you haven't upgraded everything and you decide to replace your gateways that you need new and more performance. The Gen 10 box cannot be installed on a lower version than R8030. Then you need to check what version do you have and what version do you need to go on your management station. Of course, the easiest to go to R8030.something or R8030 and then a hotfix on top of it. That's the easiest one. But if we check the compatibility list here, the compatibility map, I mean, you could, for example, have an R8020 management station and install an R8030 gateway. You can even have an R8010 management station and install an R8030 gateway. And I myself, I did have my management station on R8020 when I installed my first gateways running R8030. So it's not impossible, it works fine, but you cannot use all the functionalities. And when you push policy and so on, it will complain that you have a too low or too high version or so on. So how to wrap this up? Well, it's important for us as a security admins to keep up with the trends, and it's important for us to actually upgrade our versions, our environment to keep up to date. And for us to be allowed to upgrade, let's say 2, 3, 4 times a year, it needs to work. So the version that you're going to upgrade to needs to be stable enough to allow you to have service windows. So for example, if you fail a service window, it's harder for you to get the new service window. So do your homework before you doing it in full production. And if you need assistance in upgrading, reach out to Checkpoint or their partners. I mean, they have help. You can purchase like Checkpoint Professional Service to help you. And each and single release that comes out, for example, R81, it has added a function for us as security admins to upgrade our versions much, much easier. So each release that the Checkpoint is doing is to improve both the securities and improve the functionalities, because, I mean, Checkpoint, as all the other security vendors, they realize that we don't get more staff, we just get more to do. So we need to work smarter and better. And the vendors need to help us with this. And Checkpoint is doing this by automating some functions. They have changed how IPS works, so you don't need to think about it so much. They have changed how SIM Infinity works, like multi-queue, for example, Secure Excel, how those functions work with the dynamic dispatchers and dynamic allocated cores and so on. This is so you don't need to tweak so much when you do new installations, because Checkpoint should be able to adapt to your environment. So I would like to finish with, like, it's not enough that you only upgrade when you upgrade your boxes. You need to upgrade more frequently, because if you're running like an appliance box, that should be replaced within 3 to 5 years. You need to upgrade more often than 3 to 5 years. I would say that you minimum need to upgrade once a year. If you can, you should upgrade like once a year. At the minimum, where you have the highest level of production, where you're the most scared of doing something wrong. But it's good to look it over, let's say every quarter, like every 4 months, every 3 months, look over, is there something new that you need? Are there some bugs that you see is critical? And ask Checkpoint for help if you need it. It's also good to check in the Checkmates community. I mean, there is a lot of people there checking and answering questions. Of course, Checkpoint would say, like, use the widest recommended release. I agree to that in some extent. My personal view is for gateways, the HFA needs to be above 100 before I use them. So if we, for example, check R8040, that is the wider recommended release. So we do, let's see where I'm logged in here. Support center. Let's see, R8040, Jumbo. So as of today, this is the widely recommended version. The take is 89. So me personally, I don't install this on gateways, because this number is below 100. And that's just a rule I have to myself. You can have something else. But you see here that it comes fairly new. A lot of fixes. And if we go back, let's say, to R8030, Jumbo hotfix. The current GA for R8030 is 226. So you can see the list here is super long of fixes. A lot of these fixes are, of course, already done within R8040. So don't get me wrong here. There is a translation list that you can check. But my rule of thumb for important gateways where I have, where it's a problem for me if something breaks, is to wait until HFA above 100. I think Dorit said like, you wait the first 5 hotfixes. But if you need a specific function in a specific place, maybe check it out. But, well, I'm a bit more careful when it comes to gateways for management servers. I'm already running R8040. I actually have R81 in full production as well. So management servers, I think, is a different thing. Gateways, I try to be more conservative. So management servers, I already have R8040, I already have R81, and they are working fine. Gateways, the highest version that I have in production is R8030 with the latest general availability hotfix. So I think that's it, and thank you for sticking with me if you managed to stay all this time for a lot of mumbling. So I hope to see you in the next one. Take care. Bye.